Well, look, I think it's a sign of your lack of self-worth and the lack of comfort on who you are if you wobble every time someone says something about you. So just check yourself, and are you taking this maybe a little bit personally? That's point number one. Number two is, there's a difference between hater comments and critical feedback. And I like to think and always try and learn to know the difference between the two. So often people get good feedback in the critical form and they spaz out and have some kind of social online meltdown about it and some big argument, when in fact it's good feedback. And the only reason I've been able to grow my businesses is because people have cared enough about me and had the courage to give me feedback privately and publicly. And I feel grateful when people critique me, because it means they're comfortable enough with their relationship with me that they can say that. Then, take that aside. In the balanced view, there are just people who are blurting out a load of shit that's a load of nonsense. So block them. Just fucking block them. Like, don't spend your life worrying about them, because it's just a massive time drain. But psychologically, we're wired to be more interested. I think it's like a 3 or a 5 to 1 ratio in negative than positive, because it helps our survival. So, you know, when you see a good debate going on, you know, when people put those popcorn gifts up when there's a big debate going, we all love to watch. It's like watching someone be sick. You're like, they're going to be sick, I don't want to watch them, I'm not going to watch them. They were just sitting, you watch them, you can't help but watching it. It's like a sadomasochistic thing. If it gets to hate, then I would definitely, if it gets to bullying, then you might want to report it. But really, people aren't trolling me or being negative or critical towards me when I say some things. Their experiences and judgments, their whole life, something I'm saying is stoking that, and then they're projecting that onto me. And I know that to be the truth, because they don't know who I am. And when I say I mean all of us, we. So, you know, people are just bringing their own baggage. Now, sometimes that baggage is in the form of a good question. Sometimes that baggage is in that they can't emotionally handle what you're saying, or you've stoked up some real pain they had in their life. And just something, you know, sometimes your face just reminds them of it. So I think when you're aware of all those things, you can take it in context. And of course, money exaggerates human beings' traits. So money exaggerates. Now, look at that wanker in his Ferrari. Who does he fucking think he needs Ferrari? You know, but he doesn't. This person doesn't know that since I was 4, you know, I dreamed of having all these supercars. I used to work really hard all week doing the bottling up at my dad's pub. And I used to go down to the pound shop because he'd pay me £1 a week. And buy a picture of a Corvette, a picture of a Ferrari, a picture of a Porsche. And I dreamed of having all those things. And then for years and years and years, I worked really hard and got nowhere. And then when I could afford to get one, that was like a life's dream for me. We're all different. And I think when you understand people and care to see it from their point of view, you know, if people are like, oh, well, you know, money isn't just all about money and wealth isn't just all about riches, it's about happiness and balance. I agree, it is. It is about balance. Don't become the richest person in the graveyard, and don't be a greedy, evil bastard and just steal off everybody just to make more money for yourself. But people are watching this aren't going to be doing that. I think you can balance the paradox of greed and growth, of giving and receiving, and you can become more and more wealthy and help more and more people around you, your family, your friends, your clients, become more wealthy.